Did you know that there are three distinct types of E2 visas? Hi, I'm Jennifer Chua, an immigration lawyer at Visa to America. First, there is the Treaty Investor Visa, otherwise known as the Investor E2. This is what most investors use to start a business in the United States, meaning they put in money to the US. Second, there is the Dependent E2 Visa, otherwise known as the Derivative E-Visa. This visa is being issued to the dependents of the main treaty investor for E2. Last but not the least, there is an employee E2 visa, and I'll tell you everything you need to know about this type of E2 visa. So first, what exactly is an employee E2 visa? An employee E2 visa is given to applicants who are employees of an investor. But wait, not all employees qualify for this visa. So the next question is, how do I qualify for an employee E2 visa? Generally, to qualify for an employee E2 visa, the employee of the treaty investor must be, first, be the same nationality of their principal alien employer, owning at least 50% of the shares if there are two or more owners, otherwise known as the investor E2 visa. Or, second, if the principal alien employer is not an individual, then the enterprise or organization must be at least 50% owned by persons in the United States who have nationality of the treaty country by the same nationality, sponsoring you to go to the US. Third, this employee must be directly engaged in duties of an executive and supervisory character, or an employee who has special qualifications. Fourth, this employee must have proven degree of expertise, and the nature of the future position must be stated. For example, Martha, an Italian national, is a treaty investor in the US, and her corporation is named Blue Corp. The corporation is owned by two other individuals who are from Singapore and Spain, respectively. She wants to bring in Romero, one of her trusted employees, to manage the business there in the US. So the first thing that Martha needs to do is to determine if Romero qualifies for the employee E2 visa. Here, Martha must ensure that she owns at least 50% shares in Blue Corp for Romero to qualify as an employee E2 visa. Second, Martha must also ensure that Romero is of Italian nationality, since that is another requirement set forth by law. Third, Martha must cross-check if Romero's nature of job falls under executive and supervisory character, or if Romero has special qualifications. Once all of these are in order, Romero is qualified to apply for the employee E2 visa. And that's it. I hope you learned something from this video. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.